grave and frivolous. I wish that these white salt marks would appear sooner than the first streaks of gray in your hair. Do not be afraid to crumple a dirtier castle, coming to the rescue of the needy and the wounded. Do not hesitate to tear it up, to make bandage and dressings for human wounds. Remember that if need be, it could be converted into a cloak or even a tent. May it quickly show traces of wear and tear on your mother's knees and on her shoulders, signs of your prayer and bearing other people's burdens. May it not show such signs on the behind or the elbows, indicating you have sat down a lot or elbowed your way through the crowd. Love your cassock, but do not love yourself in it. First and foremost, love the church who has given it to you. And most of all, love Jesus, who has given you his church, and who has offered you to the church, for which I am so grateful. More and more people will look at you. After all, the Cassock does give you a lot of visibility, but it also can intimidate. And there might be some who are not brave enough to criticize you. This doesn't mean, however, that there's never grounds for criticism. Remember that your Cassock is not the packaging of a completed product. The Lord has clothed you in it to mercifully cover over your deficiencies. And now that you know this, blessed are you if you behave accordingly. Blessed are you, men, here today, all of you, especially those who are wearing this for the first or very recently first time. Know that you have been clothed in his love. He smiles upon you and gladly accepts your yes to seek and follow his will in life. Saint Therese discovered this beautiful vocation simply to love. And that's that.